Bitwig Studio has a highly advanced and extremely flexible unified modulation system. It contains over 40 different modulators that allow you to control parameters at every level of the program, from devices and tracks to global settings. In this video, we'll provide a general introduction to the Unified Modulation System. We'll show you how it works and what makes it so powerful. Let's start with the basics. This modulator icon appears throughout Bitwig Studio. Clicking the icon in the track header opens the track's modulator pane, and clicking any plus icon here opens the modulator browser. There are over 40 modulators of various categories available, from typical LFOs to step sequencers or even more unusual signal generators. Let's start simple with a classic LFO. Clicking the modulator icon on the modulator itself enables routing and illuminates all possible targets. Now just click and drag a parameter like the track's pan control to set the range of modulation. You can exit routing mode by clicking the button again or pressing the escape key. Clicking on the modulator unfolds its additional controls. Each modulator can control multiple parameters. In the case of a track modulator, you can target the track's mixer controls as well as all device parameters. Holding the Alt key temporarily disables routing, allowing you to change the base value of a parameter. And modulators can also go directly into any device, including instruments, note effects, audio effects, hardware devices, and they can even control your third-party plugins. Let's see where we can take this synth bass using Bitwig's modulation system. We'll use an LFO to modulate the pulse width of the oscillator for a gentle tone shift. The expressions modulator allows note parameters to affect device-level controls. For example, you can use the velocity of each note to modulate the instrument's filter cutoff. We can also use the filter to create a slight wobble effect by duplicating the LFO and mapping it to the cutoff as well. First, we'll find a good speed and synchronize it to the project, and then we can dial in the amount and apply a slight fade in. We can also add some punch with a pitch envelope. So let's add another ADSR, and we'll make it really short. Then assign it to pitch. And maybe it can add some noise as well. Many of Bitwig's devices have slots for nesting additional devices, like effects. Modulators from the top device can modulate the devices contained within the effect slot as well. Let's try that with a nested frequency shifter device and modulate it with the synth's internal filter envelope. All modulation routings are listed in the inspector panel. Here you can move and copy each routing, edit, bypass, or delete them. Shape the signals, or even scale it with another modulator. And when you save this patch as a device preset, that preset includes all its modulators and all the nested effects. Not only can anything in the parent device be modulated, modulators can also modulate other modulators. For this example, we'll use organ, which is a simple instrument where drawbars set the levels of different harmonics. But instead of keeping it a static sound, we'll use modulators to bring it to life. To do this, we'll start with a random and set it to hold for each note played, and then assign it to a drawbar. Next, we'll take another LFO, and this time we'll make it unipolar so that it only modulates upward. Since random is creating unique values, we can use those to tweak each note's LFO. And we've put a simple note transpose into the organ's note effects slot here, which lets us push notes around by octave. So let's give our random modulator one last task, to randomize the octave of each note. Bitwig's instruments and grid devices uniquely offer per-voice modulation. This means modulators can treat each simultaneously played note individually, which creates a richer and truly polyphonic sound. Right-click on a modulator to enable per-voice modulation. The modulator's routing button is now green, and its display also changes to show the individual modulation of each voice. Let's try it on the panning as well. Or let each note advance across the wavetable. With some wiggle on top. Or we can let each voice complete its own run through the filter. When anything can be modulated, everything becomes an instrument. Try it today in Bitwig Studio.